ovarian tumors. WHO classification of ovarian tumors. There are four types. First is surface epithelial tumors, sex cord stromal tumors, germ cell tumors, and the metastatic cancer. So these are the four classifications of ovarian tumors. First, let's see about the surface epithelial tumors. The histological types are serous, mucinous, and endometrioid types. The degree of proliferation of the epithelium, it can either be benign, borderline, or malignant. First, the serous ovarian tumor, under which let's see about benign tumor, also called as cyst adenoma. It has a smooth lining and there is no papillary projection. Microscopically, it consists of ciliated columnar epithelium. There is no invasion as it is benign and there is only minimal proliferation. Next is borderline serous tumor. In borderline serous tumor, there is moderate epithelial proliferation and presence of ATPR, and even here there is no invasion. Next is malignant serous tumor. Here the cells are well proliferated and invasion is seen as it is malignant. Only malignancy shows the property of invasion. Next, grossly, the cyst contains clear watery fluid and more commonly it is unilocated. Previously we saw about the serous ovarian tumor. Now coming to the mucinous ovarian tumor. It can either be benign, borderline, or malignant. In benign mucinous tumor, it is a large cyst with mucinous fluid. And in borderline, there is cellular ATPR, but there is no invasion. Whereas in malignant, there is invasion along with cellular ATPR. So the only difference between borderline and malignant is, there is no invasion in borderline, whereas there is invasion in malignant. Gross. There is multilocated cyst in mucinous ovarian tumor. And the cyst contains sticky, semi-solid mucinous material. So there is cyst as well as solid regions. So these are the cysts with thick viscous fluid and these are the solid regions. These are the cyst. Microscopically, it is lined by the intestinal type of epithelium. Next are the germ cell tumors, which include dysgerminoma, teratoma, and the yolk sac tumor. First, let's see about dysgerminoma. This is similar to the seminoma of the testis. More commonly occurs in the age group 20 to 30 years in females. And this dysgerminoma expresses OCT3, OCT4, and NANOG genes, and it also expresses KIT. Morphology. It can range from small nodules to the large mass. It is firm and encapsulated, and monotonous cells are present with clear cytoplasm, and the nuclei are large, centrally placed, and there is lymphocytic infiltration in the stroma. This is the morphology in case of dysgerminoma. The next type of germ cell tumor is teratoma. A teratoma is of three types: mature teratoma, immature teratoma, and monodermal teratoma. Mature teratoma is benign and this is the most common germ cell tumor. Whereas the immature is rare and it is made up of solid and bulky mass. The monodermal teratoma This is a specialized type in which it is composed of only one type of tissue entirely. So this is called as monodermal. It is composed of only one type of tissue entirely. Grossly, the mature teratoma shows structures from all the three germ layers like hair, sebaceous glands, teeth and smooth muscles. So all these can be present in the mature teratoma. In immature teratoma, there is presence of immature nerves, cartilage or bones grossly. And in monodermal teratoma, it is of two types, stroma ovary and carcinoid syndrome. First, in stroma ovary, this produces thyroid hormone. And in carcinoid syndrome, this produces a hormone called serotonin. The next type of germ cell tumor is the yolk sac tumor. This is also called as endodermal sinus tumor. This is the second most common tumor of the germ cell tumor. Origin of yolk sac tumor. This is from the differentiation of the malignant germ cells from the extra embryonic yolk sac lineage. So there's differentiation of malignant germ cells from the extra embryonic yolk cell lineage. Microscopically, there is characteristically a structure called as Schiller dual body. This is characteristic to the yolk sac tumor. In the Schiller dual body, it is comprised of central blood vessels which is surrounded by the germ cell layers. So this structure is called as Schiller dual body, characteristically seen in the yolk sac tumor. Next, coming to the sex cord tumors. This includes granulosa cell tumor, Sertoli cell tumor, Leydig cell tumor and Sertoli Leydig cell tumor. Let's see about the granulosa cell tumor. This is commonly seen in postmenopausal women and this is low grade malignant. Clinical features seen in granulosa cell tumor is there is increased secretion of estrogen. This is because the granulosa cells secrete estrogen. Here it is granulosa cell tumor, so there is increased secretion of estrogen. Microscopically, there is coffee bean appearance and characteristically the Kahl-Exner body. The Kahl-Exner body is characteristic of granulosa cell tumor and so is the coffee bean appearance. The other sex cord tumors, that is Sertoli cell tumor, Leydig cell tumor and the Sertoli Leydig cell tumors are seen in males. The last is metastatic tumor, which comprises of Krukenberg tumors. The Krukenberg tumors are common in age group of 30 to 60 years of age, which are metastatic tumors. So the source from which it is metastasized are stomach, large intestine and the breast. So from all these places, it can metastasize into the ovary, leading to Krukenberg's tumor. Microscopically, it consists of mucin producing signet cells. So these are the signet, that is ring shaped cells, which are mucin producing, and the nucleus is pushed to the periphery. This is the mucin producing cells in which the nucleus is pushed to the periphery. This is the metastatic tumor. So these are about the ovarian tumors. The ovarian tumors include surface epithelial tumors, sex cord stromal tumors, germ cell tumors and the metastatic cancer. Thank you.